career. And the question is, what are the most serious, what are the most serious environmental threats facing us today, and what federal legislation would you introduce to mitigate those environmental threats?
What are the most serious environmental threats facing us today, and what legislation would we introduce to mitigate those serious environmental threats?
Got it.
Okay. Hey, I can repeat the question. I believe that the two of the most serious threats are the threats to our oceans and the threats to our clean air. I think the Bush administration has gutted the Clean Air Act and has made a mockery of the whole concept of making polluters pay, and therefore we have to go back and restore many of the provisions and certainly strengthen regulations that have been gutted under this administration. When we talk about our oceans and we talk about what's happening with the oceans, we're actually talking about part of the destabilization of the entire ecosphere, and that links to global warming. So we have to deal with the global warming issue. I'm not quite sure what legislation I would introduce, because I do know that we have to pursue a reduction in carbon emissions, and that actually doesn't give us the option of ethanol, because ethanol increases carbon emissions rather than reducing them. So we have to deal with those issues. But I would certainly be supportive of all efforts and work with those who know what's going on. Thank you.
I am not certain what legislation I would introduce, but I do know that we have to find the alternative fuels in order to survive here. I know that the use of fossil fuels in our society has created a real threat to us because of our rush to get oil from other areas that have been very hostile to us. If we can put men on the moon, if we can send robots to Mars, we can certainly, with the emphasis of the Congress, make sure that we use everything within our power to create alternatives: wind power, water power, hydropower. We have the ability to do that, and I think that will happen not necessarily through legislation, but the will of an executive that is not being fed by oil companies that are making big profits as a result of their, basically bonanza in terms of generating profits. Thank you.
I think, Chris hit it on the head with this. The problems, the air pollution and the related problems of global warming, and then air pollution particulate matter here at home, that's part of the reason one out of eight kids in the city has asthma, and then clean water. Here's what I do. I build on what I've done in the council. I did the bill to get taxis to start going to gas electric hybrids. That's two-thirds less pollution. When that's all 13,000 cabs, that's a material difference. I sued ExxonMobil to get them to clean up the oil spill, 17 million gallon oil spill that they left here in Brooklyn 50 years ago. That's, I think those are the reasons Lee Conservation Voters has endorsed my candidacy. I'd build on that. Congress, I'd say, automakers, 40 mile per gallon fuel efficiency standard, fleet-wide, 2011, 2012, not 50 years in the future, do it now. Massive investment in alternative fuels. That's absolutely right. You know, when we did it with the Apollo project, we did it with the Manhattan project, more frighteningly, we can say we're going to put the money and the minds to work and get the alternative energy plan that we need.
Global warming, alternative fuel sources, clean air, all relates to this country not having a very serious, comprehensive energy policy. One of the things that we have to do as a country is come up with an energy policy. When we, as a country, distribute money to different states, for example, through the Department of Transportation, we need to make a requirement of those states and those localities to really put in a serious infrastructure for mass transit to reduce the emissions, to change the culture of people using cars to go everywhere, to put in mass transit systems in those localities so that they could really, really have an efficient system of transportation. This is all a part of an energy policy that we do not have as a country, something that we kind of talk about but never get to. So even though that piece of legislation will probably be a very comprehensive piece of legislation that won't be developed in the first year, but that's where we need to end up, which will deal with all of these problems.